This is one of the most difficult types of time maps to create. It is hard because of the big changes in light conditions. There are a couple of ways to create such time maps. The first and easiest one that I don't recommend is to set your camera to aperture priority mode. That way the camera will change its shutter speed automatically when it gets darker. I don't recommend this approach for creating day to night sequences because it produces a lot of flickering. The reason for the flicker is that the camera white metering system is not accurate enough and that each f-stop is divided by 3 steps as you can see on the picture. Each step from 1/3 to 2/3 and to 3/3 of the stop causes change in the exposure of the image that when played back as a movie appears as flicker. The second way to achieve this type of time-lapse is to use software called Aware Time-lapse and Twightroom using the Holy Grail workflow, which I'm going to show you right now. Here we are in Aware Time-lapse and we are going to load our day-to-night sequence, which I shot in RAW format as you can see. So we need to click and load the sequence, and as you can see the Aware time-lapse transferring the EXIF data into XMP files, and we need to click initialize so we can initialize the sequence, and once it's initialized we can start working. So I'm going to pause the video until the sequence is completely initialized and come back to continue. Here is the sequence fully initialized, and as you can see from the preview we have some jumps in the exposure, and basically the way you shoot this is you put your camera with the proper exposure, and once the light decreases with one f-stop you need to dial back your shutter speed, so choose a slower shutter speed to increase the exposure with one f-stop. And now we are going to fix that in Aware time-lapse and Twightroom. We are going to fix these jumps here in the light. As you can see we have like a lot of jumps here, and for this tutorial I'm going to use the basic workflow tab here. You can use the deflicker workflow, which has the deflicker option, but what I found is that when I'm doing a day to night transition and I use Aware time-lapse to create and smooth out the jumps in the exposures, I find that deflickering the sequence can have a negative result. So what I'm doing when I create and remove all the exposure jumps and create a smooth transition between the day to night transition, I export the sequence as a JPEG format and import it again in Aware time-lapse. Again, initialize the sequence and after that only deflicker the sequence and export it if needed. This specific sequence doesn't need deflickering because it's pretty smooth. As you can see, there are no changes in the exposure right here that are caused by the camera shutter or aperture, because I used the lens twist method for this one and it came out pretty good. So what we need to do is to actually, before we start, you can use the Holy Grail workflow to create the jumps, and this takes care of all the work you need to create in Lightroom. But if you use the old version, which is version 2, you have only the basic workflow. Actually you have this type of workflow only there, and I prefer to use the basic workflow because this Holy Grail workflow, it does work good, but I prefer to do it manually, and for the sake of this tutorial I'm going to use the basic workflow to show you how to do it. So let's click on the basic workflow tab and we need to click the keyframes wizard, and we have dialog box which tells us that Smaller adjustments in aperture and shutter speed or ISO have been skipped, and they were probably caused by the camera automatics. And no holy grail keyframes pairs have been generated for that adjustments. And we click OK, and we see that we have two keyframes here, one keyframe before the exposure jump and one keyframe after the exposure jump. And once we are ready with this, we just need to click save, and basically that's it. Now we need to jump in Lightroom and we need to import the sequence. So I'm going to click here to load the images and click import, so I can import the sequence. And as you can see, this is the progress bar which shows the sequence import, and we need to click on filter and choose aware time-lapse all keyframes. And as you can see, that starts to load all the images that have stars or ratings. So the one star is the first frame or keyframe of our sequence. The two star image is the keyframe before the holy grail jump, and the three star image is the keyframe after the holy grail jump. So everything is loaded here, and as you can see, we have like 10 or 11 jumps. And what we need to do is to click on the first image and go to the develop module of our time-lapse of Lightroom, excuse me, and the white balance is okay. We need to bring down the highlights, increase the shadows, and let's see, increase the quality, maybe set it to 100% just for the sake of the tutorial, and increase the vibrance with 25%. And also we can add a bit of a contrast here, just like so. And now what we need to do is to select the first photo, go to settings, copy settings, check all, and just copy the settings and paste them here. Now we need to go to settings and paste settings, and as you can see, this pastes the settings here. And since we have a big change in the exposure, here we are one step down from the proper exposure, so we need to click on the exposure and set it to 1 to increase the exposure. And if we select this image and go to settings and copy settings, we again copy all the settings, select the next image, go to settings again and paste the settings. And as you can see, we have exactly the same settings, but the difference is that this image is with the regular exposure, and when we paste the settings, we increase the exposure with 1 f-stop. So this is overexposed with 1 f-stop. And what we need to do is to select this image here and hold down control and select the second one and go to settings and select match total exposures. And when we click that, basically this one evens the exposure between the two photos. And actually it does pretty good job. Sometimes you don't have to tweak this, but in this case we need to tweak it a bit. So let's set this to 0, and you can toggle between the photos to see if the exposure jump is okay. So it works fine here. We need to select our second image, go to settings, copy the settings, go to the second keyframe. Actually this is the fourth keyframe, and this is the first keyframe of our second jump here. And we need to go to settings and paste the settings. And again we need to increase the exposure with 1, go to settings, copy the settings, go to the next frame, and let's paste the settings. Again select the keyframe before the jump with the 2-star rating. Make sure you always select this keyframe, hold down Control, select the second one and go to settings and choose match total exposures. And if we toggle between the photos, we can see that the jump is perfectly smooth. And basically we select this image here with the 3-star rating and just copy the settings again and let's paste them again here, and we need to increase the exposure with 1 f-stop, and maybe we can increase the shadows here to 100% and go to settings, copy the settings and let's paste the settings here, and again repeat the same step, just match the total exposures, and that's it. Basically we have to repeat these steps for all the jumps until the end of our sequence. So as you can see, this is pretty easy thing to do, and I'm not going to waste your time watching me how I repeat the same process over and over again until I fix all these jumps here. So I'm going to pause the video and do all the jumps and come back when I'm ready, so we can see what we need to do in our time-lapse once we are ready here, and finally reload all the metadata files for the full sequence and export the sequence and see the preview. So I'm starting to fix all these jumps here and we'll come back when I'm ready. Here we are again, I'm almost ready. I have to select this last keyframe and just copy the settings and paste them to the last one, and as you can see the white balance is way off here. So you can do, what you can do is to select the last image here and just set it to something like 2600, and this is going to be completely smooth when we create the transition. So it's going to smoothly change the white balance over time from this keyframe to this keyframe here, and we can select all the images and right click and go to metadata and save metadata to files, and all the metadata is saved. We need to go back to our time-lapse and just click reload. As you can see here are the jumps, and we need to click auto transition and basically click save, and once we go back to white room we want to see the our time-lapse full sequence, and select one of the pictures, hit Control A to select all of them and just right click, go to metadata and read in metadata from files and click read, and now we are reading the metadata for the full sequence with all the adjustments that our time-lapse did, with all the jumps smoothed out here. And if Flickr appears after that, what we can do is to take the exported JPEG sequence from white room and load it again here, so we can import it and use the deflicker workflow or some of the other deflicker solutions. You can deflicker if there is a minor flicker in After Effects using the GB deflicker plugin, or using Virtual Dub with the MSU deflicker plugin for it. So whatever you do, it will work. Let's go back to white room, and as you can see we have some nice smooth transition between the day and the night time. And now we need to go to the file export, and we need to specify our output folder, choose the format and the quality and click export, and that's it. So I'm going to export this sequence and you can see what it looks like after everything we did in our time-lapse and white room. The third way to create Holy Grail timelapse is using a technique called bob ramping, or also known as bramping. External complex intervalometer device is used to achieve this result. You basically put your camera in bob mode and the intervalometer overrides your settings with the settings you dial on it. Basically, what it offers is to make a really fine adjustments between the f-stops. It can make more than 100 steps of light adjustments between two f-stops compared to the built-in in your camera 3 steps between each f-stop. There is a fourth way to achieve bob ramping, and as far as I know, only Canon users can benefit from it. You need to put an external software called Magic Lantern on your memory card and load it on your Canon DSLR to get this option. Magic Lantern adjusts your shutter and ISO accordingly while the light changes to create a smooth transition. If you own a Canon DSLR and you're interested, you can go to the Magic Lantern website and learn more about this solution. It is free and easy way to create somewhat satisfactory day-to-night transition timelapse. However, it isn't nearly as good as our timelapse workflow or using bob ramping device. There is a fifth way to create day-to-night time-lapse transition. You need to shoot two separate time-lapses. One during the daytime and one during the nighttime, and after that make a simple fade transition in post to simulate the day-to-night transition. Here we are in After Effects, so I can show you how to create this. It's pretty easy thing, but I just wanted to mention a few things for this type of time-lapse. So first of all, let's change the resolution to something smaller, and the only thing that you have to consider when shooting such type of time-lapse and you plan to create the transition from day to night in that way is you need to shoot a bit more, because maybe you want 1 or 2 or maybe 3 or 5 seconds to be the transition. And honestly, 1 to 2 seconds work pretty good in most of the cases. You just need to fade to create this type of transition, as you saw from the preview. And it's not the best type of transition, because if we zoom here, especially in some parts like the windows, you can see how it looks like. It doesn't look natural, but if you create shorter transition like a second or two, it will work better. And basically you need to experiment and try different things. You can try 1 second, 2, 3, 4 or 5 seconds, depending of your personal taste. So that's it. That's about how to create a day to night transition with this technique here. And that's it for the tutorial. Hope you like it and find it useful, and it will help you for your time-lapse projects. Once again, I'm Stefan for Tuts Plus, and we'll see you next time.